Hello everyone, my name is Nitin Authare from Indian Institute of Technology, Bombay. I am here to present ICPE 2021 paper, Renoir, Accelerating Blockchain Validation Using State Caching. This is the combined work I did with Saurabh Das from University of Illinois, Professor Vinay and Professor Umesh from Indian Institute of Technology, Bombay. So here is the agenda of today's presentation. First, I'll walk you through the background required to understand this work. Then I'll explain what motivates us to do this work, followed by which protocol design. And lastly, I will comment on how we have evaluated our protocol. So the first question is, what is blockchain? Blockchain is a sequence of block where each block include identifier to the previous block and hence form the chain. Each block consists of set of transaction. A transaction can be calling some smart contract computation, or it can be as simple as transferring some money from one party to another party. User create this transaction and submit it to the node, followed by which a node broadcasts it to the network. Smart contract consists of set of state variable and function which access and operate on the state variables. State is basically a key value pair where key is a state variable address and value contained in the state variable represents the state of the smart contract at particular time instance. Contract calling transaction update this variable and hence it update the state. For example, let's say SI minus 1 is the previous state and TI is the state of transaction that are executed on top of SI minus 1. Because TI update the state SI minus 1, it will result into new state SI. Because we have used Ethereum in this work, I'll explain the state update and block processing in the Ethereum. Each node in Ethereum after receiving a transaction, it store the transaction in the data structure called transaction pool. After receiving a block, node validate it by executing all the transaction enclosed in it and update the state. Followed by the validation, node create the next block for which it will select the subset of transaction from the transaction pool based on certain criteria. For example, in this diagram, node have validated the block BI and create the block B-I+1. After the block creation, lastly, node will start proof of work POW, which is also called a mining on the created block. Mining is basically a heavy computation to solve the cryptographic puzzle. While node is doing POW on the created block, it either get the solution to the puzzle or it get the block from another node in the network, after which it will discard its own block and start validating the received block. From all this we can see that block validation, block creation and POW is a sequential process, and if the block validation time increases, it will get less time for POW and reduce the chances of getting solution to the puzzle. So the consequences of large validation time are as follows. It will slow down the chain extension and hence it will limit the throughput. It will also introduce the well-known verifier dilemma. Lastly, it will lower the effective mining power. So the fast mechanism to faster block validation is essential, particularly when the block validation time is longer. The observation which motivate us to design the Renoir is we observe that node discard the execution of block creation phase completely while validating the block. It execute all the transaction included in it in the received block, though it might have executed the same transaction as a part of block creation. For example, in the diagram, we can see that intersection of transactions in the received block bi and the potential block b dash i is not empty. It contains tx0, tx3 and tx4. But while validating the received block, it will execute all the transactions. So the question is, can we use the result of block creation phase to validate the block instead of completely discarding it and executing all the transactions in the received block as a part of validation? So the answer for this is yes, but the reusing result of block creation phase to validate the block is non-trivial. As we can see from the diagram, if the block is created with ordering tx1 followed by tx2 and vice versa, it will create a different final state. So the ordering of the transaction inside the block inside the block matters. So what can be solution for this? So dependent transaction should maintain the same relative ordering in the received block and potential block, then only that particular transaction result can be used to validate the received block. So what is the meaning of maintaining the relative ordering of the transaction? So it means that the transaction should read the same set of state variable with each state variable have the same value in both the received block and the potential block. Now the question is, how prevalent is this situation in the real network? So we answer this question, we perform the major as a part of first contribution, we perform the measurement on the production Ethereum network, where we use the matrix as a similarity to quantify the overlap between the received block and the potential block. Similarity is the ratio of gas used by the transaction that can be skipped for the execution while validating the received block to the block gas value. Gas here is the unit of computation in the Ethereum. Now, to perform the measurement, we have deployed 10 instrumented node in 10 different geographical region. We also connect 11th node to our 10 node to validate our approach. Using this setup, we have estimated the transaction pool of each miner. For example, in the diagram, at time TN1B, our node received the block from node R. So it must have reached the node R at time TRB, which is equal to the TNB minus propagation latency between these two nodes. So node R must have validated the block B dash till time TC1, which is equal to TRB dash plus block validation time of block B dash, which we in this measurement we have taken block validation time of around 200 milliseconds. So at time instance TC1, node R will start creating the next block by selecting the subset of transaction from its transaction pool. And from figure we can see that its transaction pool at time instance TC1 only contains TX1. Using the content of transaction pool and assuming that the node will prefer higher fee transaction over lower one, we form the node's potential block at particular height. Using the estimated potential block and received block, we have calculated the amount of gas that can be saved, and hence time that can be saved while validating the received block. From the plot, we can see that over 80% of the computation can be saved for more than 75% of the block. we have validated our approach by connecting 11 node to our own 10 node. We have actually calculated the similarity of the of each block on our 10 node, and we have estimated the similarity of the block at our node from 11th node. So what we observe is that we can see that the estimated similarity is significantly lower than the actual similarity. So the actual similarity in the real Ethereum network must be greater than what we have estimated. As a second contribution, we have designed the Rainware where execution result of the block creation phase is maintained in the table, and it is used to skip the execution of transaction while validating the receipt block. Rainware does it so by ensuring the transaction to read the same version of state variable in the receipt block and the potential block. Rainware maintained two tables for this purpose. First one is key table and the second is TX table. Let's say the potential block contain set of transaction TX1, TX2 and TX3. After execution of TX1, it will make an entry to both table which record the version of particular key read by a transaction. Same is the case after the execution of TX2 and TX3. If the transaction is not writing to the key, then isWrite is set to 0 in the TX table and write value is set to null in the key table. For example, after execution of TX2, isWrite is set to 0 in the TX table for key K1 and write value is set to null for key K1 in the key table. Let's say the received block contains the transaction set TX1, TX4, TX3. We can see that TX4 is not present in the potential block, so receiving node anyways has to execute TX4, but it should make sure that execution result of TX4 should not affect the stored execution result of TX3 appear after it in the order. While execution of TX1, node will compare the version of corresponding entry in the TX table and the key table. If for all the key version is same, then we can reuse the execution result of TX1 directly without executing it. Because TX4 write on key K2, it will invalidate the entry in the key table against key K2. So while processing the transaction TX3, it will find that the row against K2 is invalid. Hence, node will re-execute transaction TX3. We have evaluated the Rainware in two ways. The first one on the production Ethereum network, and the second is we have evaluated on our 50 node setup, which mimic the property of real Ethereum network. We can see that Rainware could reduce the validation time by around 50% in the production Ethereum. In our setup, for higher block creation interval ratio, which is the ratio of block creation time to the average block interval time, for higher block creation interval ratio, Rainware takes only tiny fraction of second, while Ethereum takes over a few seconds to validate the block. Mining power utilization is the ratio of block mined by the node that end up in the main chain to that of the total number of block mined by a particular node. From the plot, we can see that even for higher block creation interval ratio, mining power utilization is hardly affected. Going further, we have plotted the mining power utilization of top 7 miners, and we can see the similar behavior for MPU of individual miner but in Ethereum, declines MPU declines more for the node with the lower mining power. For throughput, we can see that in Renoir, for higher even for a higher block creation interval ratio, throughput is hardly affected. So to summarize the work, we observed the significant amount of computation overlap in the received block and the potential block. We have seen that Renoir reduced the validation time to tiny fraction from the second by reusing the guess result of the block creation phase to validate the received block. Renoir achieved this without hampering the mining power utilization, and it also improved the throughput. Apart from this, paper includes some more interesting result like distribution of transaction and the block propagation delay in the production Ethereum network. Paper also contains the proof of correctness of the protocol. So interested reader readers are encouraged to go through the paper. Thank you.